फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू द डिस्कशन ऑन एफआरएसआर। दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट एंड इन दिस पार्ट वी शैल डिस्कस रूल 10 टू 19। दिस वीडियो हैज बीन प्रिपेयर्ड एक्सक्लूसिवली फॉर एकेडमिक पर्पजेस एंड दिस शुड नॉट बी रेफर्ड फॉर अदर पर्पजेस। फ्रेंड्स द रूल्स चेंजेस फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम, सो प्लीज बी अपडेटेड with recent developments. Well, FR 10 provides that no person shall be appointed to a post without a medical certificate of health except otherwise ordered. This means medical certificate or medical examination shall precede actual appointment. So, any person job appointment hoga koi post mein to unka मेडिकल सर्टिफिकेट देना जरूरी है। उसका मतलब वो अपॉइंटमेंट से पहले मेडिकल एग्जामिनेशन करके मेडिकल सर्टिफिकेट सबमिट करना होगा, उनके बाद वो इस पोस्ट में अपॉइंटमेंट हो सकते हैं। एज पर एफआर 11 द होल टाइम ऑफ ए गवर्नमेंट सर्वेंट इज एट द डिस्पोजल ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट एंड ही मे बी एम्प्लॉयड इन एनी मैनर रिक्वायर्ड बाय प्रॉपर अथॉरिटी विदाउट क्लेम फॉर एडिशनल रेमुनरेशन। It means the whole time of a government servant is under the disposal of the government. So government servant 24 hours के लिए government servant है and government may employ him in any manner but with proper authority. So उनके लिए he cannot claim additional remuneration. And FR 12A provides that a government servant cannot hold lien in two different posts at the same time. If a government servant on substantive appointment to any permanent post acquires a lien on that post, he automatically ceases to hold any lien previously acquired on any other post. So lien ka matlab title to a post. So a government servant dono post mein lien nahi rakh sakta hai at the same time. If wo ek पोस्ट में लियन लेता है तो दूसरा पोस्ट में उनका लियन ऑटोमेटिक खत्म हो जाता है। सो ए गवर्नमेंट सर्वेंट कैन नॉट होल्ड ए लियन इन टू डिफरेंट पोस्ट एट द सेम टाइम। एफआर 13 प्रोवाइड्स दैट वन हु हैज एक्वायर्ड ए लियन ऑन ए पोस्ट रिटेन्स द लियन व्हाइल परफॉर्मिंग द ड्यूटीज ऑफ दैट पोस्ट व्हाइल ऑन फॉरेन सर्विस or on temporary post or in offsetting post during joining time, final leave, final suspension. But the lien is not returned if he has proceeded on immediate absorption to a post service outside his service cadre post from the date of absorption or on foreign service or deputation beyond the maximum limit admissible. So job koi गवर्नमेंट सर्वेंट कोई पोस्ट में लियन एक्वायर करता है तो उनका लियन जब वो ड्यूटी उस पोस्ट में करता है लियन रहता है फॉरेन सर्विस में और कोई टेम्पररी पोस्ट में और ऑफसेटिंग पोस्ट में काम करता है तो उस पोस्ट में उनका लियन रहता है। जॉइनिंग टाइम में लियन रहता है, लीव में, सस्पेंशन में भी वो लियन उस पोस्ट में रहता है। बट जब वो कोई दूसरा सर्विस में एब्जॉर्ब होने के लिए जाते हैं और कोई फॉरेन सर्विस और डेप्टोस में मैक्सिमम लिमिट से ज्यादा रह जाता है तो उनका लियन खत्म हो जाता है, उसमें पोस्ट में लियन नहीं रहता है। एज पर 14A द लियन ऑन ए पोस्ट शैल नॉट बी टॉलरेटेड एक्सेप्ट एज मेंशन इन एफआर 13 इफ द रिजल्ट विल बी टू लीव हिम विदाउट ए लियन इन ए रेगुलर पोस्ट। द लियन ऑन द पोस्ट शैल बी स्टैंड टॉलरेटेड on acquiring a lien on another post outside the cadre on which he is born. It means the lien on a post shall not be terminated except the condition provided in the FR 13. And when a person will acquire a lien in another post, automatically his lien will be terminated. The president may transfer the lien of a government servant from one post to another post in the same cadre if he is not performing the duties of the post to which the lien relates. So only president can transfer of a lien of a government servant from one post to another post in the same cadre. On in the ground is that if he is not performing the duties in the same post to which the lien relates, on that ground president may transfer the lien of a government servant from one post to another post. But the president shall not transfer one from one post to another post carrying less pay than the post in which he holds lien, but he may do so on account of inefficiency or misbehavior or on a written request of the government servant. So president normally shall not transfer to any government servant from one post to another post if the post in the second post is carrying less pay in the first post, but he can do so on the ground of inefficiency, misbehavior, or if the government servant gives in written for such transfer from a higher post to lower post. So in these three conditions, president may transfer the lien of a government servant from one post to another post. First is inefficiency, second is misbehavior, third is on the written request of the government servant. On transfer to the lower post, the pay will be fixed at a stage equal to the pay that he was holding in the higher grade before transfer. जब कोई हायर पोस्ट से लोअर पोस्ट को ट्रांसफर होता है तो लोअर पोस्ट में उनका पे शुड बी इक्वल टू दैट ही वाज गेटिंग इन द हायर ग्रेड. इफ नो सच स्टेज इज अवेलेबल, द पे विल बी फिक्स्ड एट द स्टेज नेक्स्ट बिलो द पे ड्रॉन बाय हिम इन द हायर पोस्ट एंड द डिफरेंस शैल बी ग्रांटेड एज ए पर्सनल पे टू बी एब्जॉर्ब्ड इन फ्यूचर इंक्रीमेंट. सो जब कोई हायर पोस्ट से लोअर पोस्ट का आता है तो लोअर पोस्ट में उनका पे शुड बी इक्वल दैट ही वाज गेटिंग द हायर पोस्ट. बट इफ द सेम स्केल इज नॉट अवेलेबल देन इन द लोअर पोस्ट ही विल बी गिवन जस्ट बिलो द स्केल, बट द डिफरेंस ऑफ द पे दैट ही वाज गेटिंग ही विल गेट एंड ही वाज गेटिंग विल बी एडजस्टेड एज पर्सनल पे. And this will be adjusted also in the future increment. If the maximum of the pay scale of the lower post is less than the higher post, then the pay will be fixed at the maximum stage. Suppose what he was getting in the higher stage was more than the maximum scale of the lower post, then his pay will be fixed in the maximum stage only. After 6th Central Pay Commission, in case of a transfer to a lower grade pay, the pay in the lower pay band will be fixed at the stage equal to the pay band drawn in the higher post. However, he will be granted grade pay in the lower post, and in all cases he shall continue to draw his increment based on his pay in the pay band plus grade pay as mentioned in the lower post. So his increment all will be and grade pay will be as per the lower post. As per FR 16, a government servant shall subscribe to a provident fund, a family pension fund, or similar funds in accordance with the prescribed rules. So all the government servant must subscribe to a provident fund or a family pension fund or any type of similar fund as per the rules. As per FR 17, an officer shall begin to draw the pay and allowances attached to his tenure post with effect the date when he assumes the duty of that post, and shall cease to draw them as soon as he ceases to discharge those duties. So, जब भी कोई government servant उनका post में duty assume करता है, इस दिन से उनको pay and allowance दिया जाएगा, और जिस दिन से वो ड्यूटी से डिस्चार्ज होंगे इस दिन से उनको पे एंड अलाउंस नहीं मिलेगा. बट इफ वन इज एब्सेंट फ्रॉम ड्यूटी विदाउट एनी अथॉरिटी ही शैल नॉट बी एंटाइटल्ड टू पे एंड अलाउंसेस ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड ऑफ सच एब्सेंस. सो जब कोई ड्यूटी से विदाउट एनी अथॉरिटी एब्सेंट रहता है तो उन टाइम के लिए उनको पे एंड अलाउंस नहीं दिया जाएगा. एनी पीरियड ऑफ अनऑथराइज्ड एब्सेंस बाय द एम्प्लॉइज during strike or any reason not treated as valid by the appointing authority, or any individual employee remaining absent unauthorizedly or deserting the post shall be deemed to cause break or interruption of service. So, any unauthorized absence by the employees due to strike or for any reason like bond or token strike, which is not treated as valid by the appointing authority, or if an individual employee remain absent unauthorizedly or desert the post, then this period will be treated as cause of break or interruption of service. The break in service will affect the benefit of LTC, quasi permanency, and eligibility of departmental exemption immediately. So, what is the effect of the break in service? It will immediately affect the LTC, quasi permanency, and eligibility for departmental exemption. And if the break of service for LTC, etc., is not condoned, still the appointing authority may condone this break of service for purposes of pension without retention from the employee, so that the employees are not affected financially after retirement. So when there is a break in service, it will affect LTC, quasi permanency, and eligibility for departmental exemption, and this will not be condoned unless there will be a written representation from the government servant. But if these are not condoned, still the authority may so motto condone the break of service for purpose of pension. So without the representation of the employee, the authority can condone the break of service for purpose of pension, but not for LTC or departmental examination. Strike includes a general, token, sympathetic, or any or similar strike, participation in bond, and any strike declared illegal by provision of Industrial Dispute Act 1947. So strike kisko bolte hai? It includes a general, token, sympathetic, or similar strike, or participation in bond, or any strike jisko ki Industrial Dispute Act ke dwara illegal bataya gaya hai, unko participate karne mein वो ब्रेकअप सर्विस होगा, एंड दीज आर इंक्लूडेड स्ट्राइक. स्ट्राइक मीन्स रिफ्यूजल टू वर्क और स्टॉपेज और स्लोइंग डाउन ऑफ वर्क बाय अ ग्रुप ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज, एंड इंक्लूड्स मास एब्सटेंशन विदाउट परमिशन, रिफ्यूजल टू वर्क ओवर टाइम वेयर सच वर्क इज नेसेसरी इन पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट. सो स्ट्राइक ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स रिफ्यूजल टू वर्क और स्टॉपेज ऑफ वर्क और स्लोइंग डाउन ऑफ वर्क बाय अ ग्रुप ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज और mass absence without permission or refusal to work overtime when this work is necessary for public interest. These activities are also included as a strike. FR 18 provides that no government servant shall be granted leave of any kind for a continuous period exceeding 5 years. So no government servant will be granted leave maximum exceeding 5 years. Willful absence from duty not covered by grant of any leave will be treated as a diagonal for all purposes. These are increments, leave and pension. So, job by willfully absence rahega duty se, and this period of absence will be treated as diagonal. Jo ki increment, leave or pension ka upar unka effect aayega. But it does not entail a loss of leave. So, if some period is declared as diagonal, this will not affect on lien, but this will affect on increment, leave and pension. As per FR 19, the pay of a government servant shall not exceed then the amount sanctioned for that post. This can only be increased by the authority competent to create the post. So koi government servant ka salary will not increase that has been sanctioned for the post, and this can be increased only by the authority who is competent to create the post. So let us discuss some questions. As per FR 10, no person shall be appointed to a post without a medical certificate of health except otherwise ordered. It means medical examination shall be done, option A, after the appointment, option B, before the appointment, option C, no such restrictions. And answer is it is after the appointment. A government servant is called to duty on holidays and he demands additional remuneration for such duty on holidays. Can the authority deny the claim? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Yes, the authority can deny the claim. Whether a government servant can hold lien in two different posts at the same time? Option A, yes. Option B, no. No, the government servant cannot hold lien in two different posts at the same time. A government servant who has acquired a lien on a post does not retain the lien while on foreign service or on temporary post or in officiating post or while on suspension or none of these. The answer is none of these. In all the cases, he acquired a lien on the post. In which of the following conditions the lien of a government servant is retained? Option A. He has proceeded on immediate absorption to a post service outside his service cadre post from the date of absorption. Option B. On foreign service or deputation beyond the maximum limit admissible. Option C. During the time on transfer to another post unless he is transferred along with his title to a post on lower pay. Option D. None of these. The answer is during the time on transfer to another post unless he is transferred along with his title to a post on lower pay. In which of the following conditions the lien of a government servant shall be terminated? Option A. On acquiring a lien on another post under central government outside the cadre on which he is born. Option B. On acquiring a lien on another post under state government outside the cadre on which he is born. Option C. Both of these. Option D. None of these. The answer is both of these. In which of the following conditions the lien of a government servant may be transferred by the president? Option A. If he is not performing the duties of the post to which the lien relates. Option B. The post should be in the same cadre. Option C. Both of these conditions. Option D. None of these conditions. The answer is under both of these conditions, the lien of government servant may be transferred by the president. In which of the following condition the president shall transfer a government servant from one post to another post carrying less pay than the post in which he holds lien? Option A. On account of inefficiency. Option B. On account of misbehavior. Option C. On request of the government servant. Option D. All of these. And the answer is all of these. If a government servant is transferred to a lower post, which of the following is correct regarding his fixation of pay in the lower post? Option A. At a stage equal to the pay that he was holding in the higher grade before transfer. Option B. If no such stage is available, the pay will be fixed at the stage next below the pay drawn by him in the higher post, and the difference shall be granted as personal pay to be absorbed in future increment. Option C. If the maximum of the pay scale of the lower post is less than the higher post, then the pay will be fixed at the maximum stage. Option D, all of these. And the answer is all of these. What is the immediate effect for unauthorized absence due to participation in any strike declared illegal or not on valid reason as per authority? Option B, break in service for purpose of leave. Break in service for purpose of LTC, break in service for purpose of demobilization, all of these. And the answer is all of these. Which of the following activity is not treated as strike? General strike and participation in bond, token or sympathetic strike, mass abstention from work without permission, none of these. Answer is none of these. Which of the following benefits status of the government serving employee is not affected when willful absence from duty is treated as a disgorgement? Option A. Increments. Option B. Pension. Option C. Leave. Option D. Lien. And the answer is lien. Government servant shall not be granted leave of any kind for a continuous period exceeding 10 years. 3, 4, 5, 6. Answer is 5. Thank you. If you found the video beneficial, you may subscribe to RK Didactics and also share the video to your friends.